Welcome to this video on mini and microcomputers. This learning video will enable you to identify mini computers, identify the types of mini computers, identify microcomputers, and identify the types of microcomputers. Mini computers are smaller than mainframe computers. They also have lower processing speed than mainframe computers. However, they are much cheaper than mainframes. Therefore, microcomputers are also called mid-range computers. The capabilities of a mini computer are between mainframe and personal computers. Mini computers are used in business, education, and several government departments. Mini computers are commonly used as servers in the network environment. Hundreds of personal computers are connected to the network with a mini computer acting like a server. The first mini computer was introduced in the mid-1960s by Digital Equipment Corporation (DEC). After this, IBM Corporation, AS400 Computers, Data General Corporation and Prime Computer also designed the mini computers. Now that you are aware of mini computers, let us learn about microcomputers. Microcomputers are also known as personal computers, PCs. Microprocessors are used in these computers. They are very small and costless. The first microcomputer was designed in 1981 by IBM and was named as IBM PC. The most popular types of personal computers are the PC and the Apple. The processor and operating systems are different for these two types of computers. PCs use the Windows operating system, while Apple computers use the Macintosh operating system. Personal computers are available in two models, desktop PCs and tower PCs. A desktop personal computer is the most traditional model of personal computers. The system unit CPU of the desktop personal computer can lie flat on the desk or table. Another model of the personal computer is known as tower personal computer. The system unit CPU of the tower PC is vertically placed on the desk of a table. Usually, the system unit of the tower model is placed on the floor to make desk space free, and the user can place other devices such as the printer, scanner, etc. on the desktop. The tower models are mostly used at homes and offices. Microcomputers are further categorized as laptop, workstation, network, and handheld computers. A laptop computer is also known as a notebook computer. It is small and can fit inside a briefcase. The laptop computer operates on a special battery and it does not have to be plugged into the desktop computer. It is a portable version of a microcomputer. It is commonly used during a journey. It can be rested on your lap and hence it is referred to as laptop computer. The memory and storage capacity of the laptop computer is almost equivalent to the PC or desktop computer. It also has a hard disk, floppy disk drive, zip disk drive, CD-ROM drive, CD writer, etc. It has a built-in keyboard and trackball. A laptop computer has the same features as the personal computer. Laptop computers are more expensive than desktop computers. Generally, these computers are frequently used by business travelers. Workstations are special single-user computers that have the same features as the personal computer. The processing speed is equivalent to mini computer or mainframe computer. A workstation can be fitted on a desktop. These computers are mostly used by scientists, engineers, architects, and graphic designers. Workstation computers are expensive and powerful computers. These have advanced processors and more storage capacity than personal computers. They are commonly used as servers on the computer network and web servers. Network computers have less processing power, memory, and storage. These computers are used to access data on the network. They are commonly used as terminals for the network environment. Some types of network computers have no storage. They depend on the network's server for data storage and to use software. In the mid-1990s, the concept of network computers became popular among some PC manufacturers. Some network computers are designed to access only the internet or intranet. These devices are sometimes called internet PCs or internet boxes, etc. In some homes, network computers do not have a monitor. These are connected to home television, which serves as the output devices. A popular example of a home-based network is Web TV, which enables the user to connect a television to the internet. The Web TV has a special set-top box used to connect the internet and also provides a set of simple controls which enable the user to navigate the internet, send and receive emails, and to perform other tasks on the network while watching television. Network computers are cheaper to purchase and to maintain than personal computers. In the mid-1990s, new types of personal computing devices were introduced and they were referred to as handheld computers. These computers are also referred to as palm top computers or mini notebook computers. The handheld computers are preferred by business traveler. Some handheld computers have a specialized keyboard. These computers are also used by mobile employees such as meter readers and parcel delivery people whose jobs require them to move from place to place. Key points discussed in this video. Mini computers are smaller and cheaper than mainframes. Mini computers are commonly used as servers in the network environment. Microcomputers are also known as personal computers. They are available as desktop and tower PCs. Microcomputers are further categorized as laptop, workstation, network, and handheld computers.